Good Friday morning, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee. I'm meteorologist Austin Onick. Another hot day in the Mid-South, just not quite as hot as what it was a couple of days ago. That's something, but not great news as we head into the last weekend of summer for 2019. So at least we'll kind of take the edge off the heat. But unfortunately, the cooler autumn, crisp, nice temperatures that a lot of you have been anticipating are nowhere near in sight, and going to be continuing to see some pretty hot conditions right into the first weekend of autumn 2019 next weekend. We'll talk about that coming up here in just a little bit. If you can't stick around for the whole forecast, that's cool. Just again, right in the blue bar scrolling by at the bottom of your screen, or go to wreg.com/weather for more details on that. Join us and drop some weather into the comments section. What's going on in your neck of the woods, whether you're in the Mid-South area or not, anywhere outside the Mid-South, just give us a city, state location and say hi and see what's going on weather-wise in your area. And of course, keep it tuned to News Channel 3 throughout the rest of the weekend, and we'll keep you updated on what's coming up. Coming up on this edition of Weather Overtime, we'll talk more about the forecast into the weekend. We'll also talk about Friday Night Football, what it looks like for tonight. You're going to want to dress cool, I'll tell you that much right now for a little foreshadowing there. And into next week, unfortunately, we're not going to be cooling off. Matter of fact, unfortunately, kind of reversing trends if everything holds. We'll talk about that coming up in just a little while. And a quick peek at the tropics to see if there's anything heading our way. So stay tuned for more on that. Rest of the afternoon looking like this. Again, some chances of isolated showers and thunderstorms, pretty much like what we saw yesterday, dotting the landscape. Not a lot of them. There are some scattered showers out there right now, just past 11 o'clock this morning, but nothing huge and nothing severe. We are heading into severe weather season number two, so now's the time to get ready for that, and we'll show you how to do that coming up here in just a bit. Temperatures back in the upper 80s to right about the lower 90s. Again, that's still above normal, but it's below where we were several days ago. So some improvement, if anything, but not really all that much at this point in time. 2 days and change until the official change in seasons. Autumn begins at about 2:50 a.m. Monday, September 23rd. So again, a little bit over 2 days until the change in seasons. Wish we could say it's going to be that long until we actually cool off, like some nice 70s for highs somewhere in there. That would be very nice. It's a natty thought, but I don't think it'll catch on anytime soon, unfortunately, for right now. High temperature yesterday, still well above normal, 12 degrees above normal out there for a high temperature. 84 is where we should be. Record high for today, 100, set back last in 2010. I don't think we're going to be breaking that at this point, but it is still going to be pretty toasty out there. And again, low temperature of 77, well above where we should be for this time of the year out there for right now. Well ahead on precipitation at this time as well, looking at 15-inch surplus, but it's been days since we've seen anything in the way of any good rainfall across the Mid-South. So this weekend, we might be looking at the possibility of maybe some wildfire danger. We'll take a look at that coming up tomorrow morning on News Channel 3 Daybreak Saturday, so stay tuned for more on that. Olive Branch, Mississippi, there's some of those clouds popping up across the area from former mayor, current meteorologist Sam Reichert's Weather Underground camera at the Olive Branch Airport. This is kind of nice right here, 82 degrees, 4 degrees cooler than what it was yesterday at this time. We still have a heat index, but those winds are helping out by just a bit. Southwest at about 10 to 15 miles per hour. That's pretty nice out there. Ray Johnson, leaves in the pool. Yeah, unfortunately, there's a lot of those coming off the trees out there. Can't see too many of them under the grounds of the trees at Windyke Country Club, with golfers out and about, grounds crew keeping the fairways clean. And you can still see some of those clouds starting to develop out there as the atmosphere gets a little bit more turbulent. Poplar Pike in Germantown, right around the area of the railroad tracks, looking northwest from around Germantown High School. More clouds out there, 84 degrees, breezy southeasterly winds at about 16 miles per hour. Rhodes College in central Memphis, blue, less than gray right now as we see the cloud cover popping up across the metro area, and more coming up into the next couple of days. Hazy with some cloud cover over Memphis International Airport, and looking again at mostly cloudy skies across portions of the Mid-South. Winds are kind of breezy, but not enough to affect arrival and departure delays at this time, so good news if you're going to be hitting the skyways pretty soon. No delays to report out there, with the exception of O'Hare in Chicago. Got some delays shaping up of about 15 15 to 30 minutes, and those are increasing. So if you'd like to check out more about what's going on with delays across the country, head to wreg.com/weather or go to the FAA website at their Air Traffic Control System Command Center for more information. High pressure in control over the southeastern United States, and that's helping to move what's left of Imelda up into the north, and that's going to be passing mainly west of us into around the Ark-La-Tex area, Oklahoma, and back into Missouri and Kansas. That much rainfall will be avoiding us for right now, but unfortunately, again, as this area of high pressure rotates clockwise in the northern hemisphere, it's going to be pushing a lot more moisture up this direction for areas, say, west of Little Rock and into areas east of Tulsa. So if you're heading west of the Mid-South, may run into some slowdowns as you hit around Pulaski County in Arkansas. Now, we do have a few scattered showers in the Mid-South for right now over parts of eastern Arkansas moving up from northern Louisiana. Nothing in the way of any severe weather. Matter of fact, at this time, we've got just light scattered showers, and that's about it. Still pretty toasty out there with, again, some numbers back in the high 80s to lower 90s on the heat index scale on live real-time WeatherNet 3, and not much better than that, unfortunately, for the rest of the day. Running the numbers, winds coming in from out of the south, and that's going to help to keep both the moisture content up and the temperature. So highs today back in the lower 90s. With the exception of where those showers come through, the numbers will be dropping a bit at times, and the clouds also blocking out some of the sunshine, so we may see less heat in parts of the area, but unfortunately it's going to be pretty toasty right on into the time that you pick the kids up from school. Back into drive time tonight, best possibility of any rainfall, again with Imelda's rain, what's left of that storm, giving us some showers and thunderstorms, most numerous west of the Mississippi River. And then into this evening, we shouldn't see too much of that left over, maybe a shower or two as we get into very early tomorrow morning. And that should do it for the rainfall for a while. The last weekend of summer should start off pretty nice, at least where it comes to, again, lack of any rainfall out there. But it looks like it is going to be continuing to be pretty warm across the area through the last weekend of summer and right on into the first week of autumn. What does that look like? Well, we'll check out the numbers on our 7-day forecast. Isolated showers and thunderstorms this afternoon and into this evening. High temperatures just above normal in the upper 80s, possibly the lower 90s, but most of the area should be again seeing the upper 80s for today. Tomorrow we'll take the chances of showers and thunderstorms out of the forecast and a mix of clouds and sunshine out there. With that humidity, it's still going to be pretty toasty. Likewise, into Sunday, temperatures rise a bit, partly sunny skies and numbers back in the lower 90s out there. Now, as we get into the first week of autumn, what does it look like? Well, unfortunately, we should be at this time frame going into the first week in the lower to mid 80s for high temperatures. We're going to be just above that again in the upper 80s to the lower 90s. Now, you're also seeing at this point in time, this is about as cool as it gets for the time being, and numbers start stair-stepping their way upwards as we go toward next Thursday. Going to be even hotter as we get into the first weekend of autumn. Yes, there will be some chances of showers and thunderstorms next weekend. Unfortunately, at this point, it looks like with a healthy dollop of heat coming in, not going to be seeing too much in the way of cooler weather anytime soon. So yes, the cooler weather is out there someplace, but for right now, just not really expecting it anytime soon. And the first week of autumn is going to wind up being a very hot one out there, especially into next weekend. So football games next Friday night could be seeing some showers and thunderstorms. And then also next weekend, a better, if not small, chance of more showers and thunderstorms. So outdoor athletic events, whatever you've got going on in the way of autumn festivals and stuff like that, going to have to keep an eye to the sky and watch what goes on out there for right now. What's left of Jerry making its way back to the northwest is a Category 2 storm, now back to a Category 1 storm after a Hurricane Hunter plane moved its way on through. What else do we have out there when it comes to anything in the way of showers, thunderstorms, or problems from the Gulf of Mexico? Well, we'll talk more about that coming up this weekend, so stay tuned for more on that. But fortunately, nothing immediate happening for the Gulf or the East Coast. Jerry's going to be curving its way back around toward Bermuda, and Umberto is basically a bad memory at this point, so there's not much left of it. Want to learn more about severe weather? Next week, last night, next Thursday, that is, September 26th at 6 p.m. at the Truman, Arkansas Fire Department, National Weather Service will be teaching Skywarn Spotter training classes. They last about an hour or so. They're totally free. Show up and get the information you need to become a volunteer storm spotter, not a chaser. Okay, that's something entirely different, and you should only be a chaser if you've been trained by experts. The spotters become, in essence, the eyes and ears of the National Weather Service out across the Mid-South and help us to see what's and listen to what's going on out there. So if you'd like to do this, first meeting of the fall semester will be coming up next Thursday. The one after that will be a little bit farther outside the News Channel 3 viewing area in Big Sandy, Tennessee. The National Weather Service covers a lot more counties than our broadcast signal does. So if you know somebody in Big Sandy, Tennessee, or around Northwest Tennessee that would like to take this course, again, totally free, have them drop by weather.gov/MEG. That's the National Weather Service website. Or just go to weather.gov, click on this area of the country on the map, and it will take you right to the National Weather Service in Memphis. Or, again, go to WREG.com for more information about what's going on out there where it comes to training for you to keep you safe across much of the area. All right, two more checks of the forecast. First one, again, looking into this afternoon, could be seeing an isolated shower and thunderstorm, and some of those could be going right up until the time that we hit the beginning portions of the setup and getting people into the stands for Friday night football. So this could be a bit of an issue out there, that if there are thunderstorms around the area by the time kickoff happens and the officials see lightning out there, there could be some delays and everybody's going to have to vacate the stands and the field, because that's one of the worst places you can be with lightning around. Yes, the storm may be several miles away. Yes, the odds are decently small to not be struck by lightning, but the important thing is, why take a chance? So make certain that everybody stays safe with thunder out there for tonight. Temperatures around kickoff time will be in the mid to upper 80s. Kickoff time tonight right before sunset, which will be at about 7:21. And through the rest of the game tonight, temperatures will be back in the mid 70s about the time the games start to wrap up later on this evening. So decently warm, definitely want to dress cool. Maybe that extra bottle of ice water to get you going, that extra thermos of ice water, just to be on the safe side. So please keep that in mind as you head out the door for tonight and try to stay cool out there for right now. Ray Johnson would love to be a spotter. Great, great attitude to have. National Weather Service and folks like me at News Channel 3 could use your help by becoming the eyes and ears out there. So thank you very much for wanting to volunteer on that. Joan Gray, Guys, Tennessee, feeling good outside today. A lot less hot than what it has been. Thank you very much for checking in from there. Thanks to everybody else for checking in from across the area for today. Francis Roberson, looking forward to cooler weather. Yes, definitely so. Not everybody, but at least a lot of us are. A lot of you out there love the hot weather and want to keep it around as long as possible. Fair enough, but you know, all good things must come to an end. So change in seasons coming up pretty soon, at least anyway. We'll have an update on the forecast with yours truly on News Channel 3 at noon. That's about a little bit less than 45 minutes away. Tim and Jim have your complete forecast coming up for the rest of the weekend, updated on First at 4 and beyond. And, of course, I'll be here throughout the rest of the weekend keeping you updated as to what's going on with Mid-South weather and beyond. Questions, concerns, comments, complaints, if you absolutely must, drop me a line at austin.onick@wreg.com or find me on social media out there all over the place. So again, if you something on here you want to see, more satellite pictures, more climate data, whatever, let me know. My psychic powers are not really doing too well, so I have to get email instead of any nice kind thoughts to come your way out there. So drop me a line, let me know, and we'll see if we can work it in here for you a little bit later on. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, I'm meteorologist Austin Onick. Thank you for joining us for today's exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime. More today on News Channel 3 at noon, and don't forget about Tim and Jim today on First at 4. Thanks for joining us.